Hey everybody, welcome back. My name is Everett Mohan, also known as Aspiring Spike on the internet. Today I have a deck that I'm really excited about. This is a Jeskai Arclight Phoenix deck that I put together for this last Friday's stream. I streamed all day with the deck, I picked up a trophy, I was really feeling it, and then I decided to play it in Saturday's Modern Challenge, and I top-8ed the event with this deck. And I've been really, really impressed by it, and I'm excited to show it off today. So let's talk about some of the more interesting deck building decisions. You know, it's felt like the last few sets, we've gotten tools for this deck. You know, Modern Horizons gave us Faithless Salvaging. The D&D set gave us Demi Lich, which is a creature very, very similar to Arclight Phoenix, in that it's, you know, recursive and powerful, and you can play it from the graveyard, and you can play it for zero mana. But just like, even though Faithless Salvaging is a very good enabler, where the rebound on this card sets you up for some very powerful turns, starting your turn with a zero mana rummage. Demi Lich is a very powerful creature, very similar to Arclight Phoenix. Every time I've played these decks in the past, I've just felt like it's so close to being a powerful deck, and just like one or two good enablers away. And Innistrad Midnight Hunt has given us two good enablers in Faithful Mending and Consider. I've been really impressed by both of these cards. I do feel like both of these cards kind of tie the room together. And I've also been very happy with this build of the deck, where a lot of people ask me why I'm not playing Dragon Rage's Channeler. A lot of people are playing Dragon Rage's Channeler, and I was too before Innistrad Midnight Hunt came out in the older versions. And Channeler is really good at like dumping your whole deck into your graveyard, which is great, of course. But you know, one powerful thing about this deck is that you're really resilient to creature removal, you're really resilient to counter spells and discard spells. And Channeler is a card that's really easy to one for one, and so playing it removes some of that resiliency. Channeler in these decks, because you're not playing Mishra's Bauble, it's kind of hard to get Delirium sometimes, especially because your creatures leave the graveyard all the time. So if your creatures have left the graveyard in combat, you can have instant sorcery land and you don't have another type. If you have another Dragon Rage's Channeler in the yard, but it could just be kind of tricky. And then it's also true that if you play Channeler, you're playing less instants and sorceries, and it's kind of harder to enable your Phoenixes and your Demi Liches. And the card you would have to cut to find room for Channeler would be Prismatic Ending. But Prismatic Ending has been so incredibly good for me in this deck. I at this point cannot see playing less than four copies, even though like my first draft, I think I was just playing three. Where, like I was mentioning earlier, this archetype is good against discard spells, counter spells, removal spells. It's soft to lock pieces like Chalice of the Void, Rest in Peace, Sanctifier, and Vec. But Prismatic Ending not only gives you an excellent answer to all of these cards, but with all your cantrips, it's pretty easy to find a Prismatic Ending to answer a lock piece. And Prismatic Ending is just a good card in Modern. It's already one of the best removal spells, if not the best removal spell. And it's also a one mana sorcery that counts towards your Phoenixes and Demi Liches, and has just been so, so perfect in the deck. I've really been liking this build. I've been liking 17 lands. I started with 18. I went down to 17. And I also think that if you pick up the deck and you want to make some changes, even though I really, really highly recommend this main deck to you, if you want to make some changes, I would not recommend playing more creatures. I've tested in the past Murktide Regent. I've tested Stormwing Entity. I've tested Dragon Rage's Channeler. I really think this deck is best built as 8 creatures, 17 lands, all instants and sorceries. And these instants and sorceries, you cannot play any more spells that cost cost 2 or more mana than we're playing. I think that 8 2-mana spells, you don't count Manamorphose, this is the hard limit for the deck, where you need to cast multiple spells in a turn to trigger your Demi Liches and Phoenixes. So if you're playing cards like Expressive Iteration, Prismari Command, more 2-mana looting spells like Izzet Charm, you are just going to stumble, and you're not going to be able to play the 3 or 4 spells you need in one turn to get your creatures back. I have tried Iteration. I know that's kind of the big card that people want to jam in these decks because it is so powerful, but it just ends up making your curve too high and your deck doesn't function as smoothly. And you know, you do generate card advantage in this deck by, you know, discarding your creatures and they come back for value or milling them over with Thoughtscour Consider. We're also playing 3 main deck Gutshot. That might be the, like, one other card in the main deck that looks a bit weird, but it's another 0 mana card which can get you up to the density of 3 or 4 spells you need for your Demi Liches or Phoenixes. And it's also pretty good in the metagame. This kills Ragavan. This kills Dragon Rage's Channeler. It kills Risen Reef. It kills some creatures out of Hammer Time. Esper Sentinel's the big one. Good to kill Ink Moth Nexus too. Definitely, I think three copies is the correct number. I can't really see playing four. And another nice thing too is that the life loss from the Gutshot and your fetch lands is sometimes offset by Faithful Mending's incidental life gain, which is kind of nice. So that being said, I really, really like this main deck. I recommend this main deck, and I really don't think that it's going to change that much in the coming weeks, coming months. I think that this is going to be the stock main deck of Jeskai Phoenix. If Jeskai Phoenix is a force in Modern, I think it has a really good chance to be. That being said, the sideboard is something I think that's going to change from week to week. So, like I mentioned, this deck is soft to Reanimator. Reanimator is kind of popular right now, so I'm playing three Surgicals on my sideboard as my answer to the Reanimator decks. That being said, if Reanimator is not popular, or if you figure out a different plan to beat Reanimator and a different deck, then you're going to not want to play Surgical. You might want to play Obsidian Charball for Tron. I think Tron's not that popular at the moment. You could play more Alpine Moons for Tron. You could play Blossoming Calm if Burn is popular. I think Burn's not a great matchup, but the Faithful Mendings do help the Burn matchup with this incidental life gain. I do think that these three Wear Tears are basically always going to be really important to be able to bring in to destroy your Rust in Pieces, Leyland of the Voids, more Chalices. But beyond these three Wear Tears, I see that the rest of the sideboard changing from week to week, where the Chalices and the Flusterstorms are for Cascade decks, the Path to Exiles are for Murktide Regent and Sanctifier Invect, the Alpine Moons are for Urza Saga and Tron matchups, and like Attention, Surgical is mostly for Reanimator. You can also bring it in the Mirror. But this sideboard is going to change a lot. So if you're wanting to pick up this deck, again, I really recommend this main deck. I feel great about it. I'm really, really proud of it. The sideboard is going to change from week to week. So that is something to remember. I'm also writing a deck guide for Channel Fireball Pro. I'm not sure if it'll be up when this video goes up. It probably will. And so you can also get a Channel Fireball Pro subscription to find the deck guide on this list there too. That being said, that's the deck. I'm really, really happy about it. Let's go ahead and jump into a week. Okay, so we won the die roll for the first match of this league. I'm going to choose to play first. For a pretty strong hand here, this is a turn two Phoenix, actually, if we can scry into a land off Serum Visions, which, of course, we have a really good chance to do. So I'm definitely going to keep even nicer, too, if we also got to gutshot an opposing creature. It'll be just an amazing turn two. Go Metamorphose, Mending, Gutshot a creature. Okay, opponent's mulled to six. Still deciding if they want to go lower or maybe deciding on what card to put back. Okay, they keep six. Fountain, Serum Visions. We do need to find a red source too. Okay, and we have one here at the Sacred Foundry. I'll go to bottom the Salvaging, top the Sacred Foundry. Pass. Love to see a one toughness creature on turn one. With a basic forest, we might. Awesome. It's gonna be a really good turn two. I'm not gonna wish for a second Phoenix. I think that's far too greedy. We'll need to save any luck for later, but I'm very happy with this first turn or first game. All right, so we'll discard the Phoenix. I might discard the second Mending here. It's kind of close. I think I'll do that. What a turn two. So we don't know exactly what Arbor Elf deck they're playing. You know, the main ones are going to be Heliod and Ponza, but seeing Temple Garden, I'm going to assume that this is Heliod combo, which I'm not sure how good or bad this matchup is. Like, yeah, cards like Ariok Champion are historically pretty rough, but we also have, you know, we fly over Champion and we have Prismatic Ending too, which is, you know, in some ways kind of considered to be the card that's pushed Heliod out of the metagame is the Prismatic Endings. So we build over just a Floodstrand and a Scour. I'm going to consider here. I think we're going to put that in the graveyard. We would need to draw a gut shot to play a Demi-Lich right now. We did draw Metamorphose, which should mean we can play Demi-Lich next turn. I am a bit worried about getting comboed out here, though. Not necessarily this turn. I mean, they could Coco into Heliod Spike Feeder, but just in general. Just in general. Okay, now I need to think, do I want to bolt the Spike Feeder now to save my mana, or do I want to save Lightning Bolt for next turn so I have a density of spells for this Demi-Lich for sure and potentially more cards? I think that I should save the Lightning Bolt. I think that I want to save it. Drew another one, which is, you know, good, I guess. Go islands, Metamorphose off Sacred Foundry Island, blue red. It's an interesting draw. Scour myself, another Demi-Lich. So I have two Demi-Liches in hand, one in the graveyard. I've cast two spells, so I'm going to Lightning Bolt the Spike Feeder, and I think I just have to bolt my opponent, so that way I can cast. I could hold this Lightning Bolt in hand, and I could just pay a blue mana for each of these liches, but I think I want to just get all three liches, and then next turn I can flashback at least two bolts. I do get to gain life, though. So you're going to go up to 16, we'll attack them down to 13. We'll see where we are after that. I'm going to exile a Salvaging. Salvaging doesn't rebound if you flash it back off Lich. So that's usually the first card I exile. Then maybe one of the two Metamorphoses and one of the Thought Scours. Oh, I have to exile one more. I can exile the third Mending. I don't think we're going to flashback three Mendings this game. Pretty good turn four. I don't know, just casting this card for zero mana from your graveyard just feels so crazy. They drew their land. They did miss a land drop last turn, so they could have a Coco here. We're dead to Heliod plus Spike Feeder. We have removed one of their Spike Feeders from their deck, though. They have a pretty good chance of being dead if they don't get us here. Okay, so they gain a lot of life. We can bolt the Conclave Mentor, they'll gain two up to 17. We can bolt them down to 14, and then we're attacking for 12 plus 3, 15, which is not quite lethal. Draw Mending, which isn't helping us that much. I also don't have any Prismatic Endings Exile Champion in my graveyard at the moment. I think what I'll do here is I'll attack with everybody. And then let's go. Let's have the third Demi-Lich, or the last Demi-Lich trigger target bolt. And then let's target Consider. And then on top of that, let's cast the Metamorphose so we can use the mana from the Metamorphose for both of these. So Metamorphose for blue red. Okay, and then the trigger for Consider resolves. We'll cast Consider. I would like to find maybe Prismatic Ending. Let's put that in the graveyard. Then the bolts. Bolt the Mentor with their floating red mana. They get two. We've got a big attack here. They're probably dead next turn. And, you know, they have two cards in hand and they're two combo pieces shy of going off. That being said, they, of course, could have a second Coco. They're jumping with one of their two champions. At six. Okay, they're pretty dead next turn. I'm just gonna pass here. I could maybe try to consider into a Gutshot or Bolt if my opponent does have another Coco and they do hit Spike Feeder Heliod, and they do have another Coco. They're not immediately slamming Spike Feeder Heliod, so I'm gonna assume they bricked or, you know, didn't find the nuts. They're deep in the tank. I shouldn't read too much into like little micro decisions or like this, but it does feel like they're dead on board and they're trying to figure out some way to survive. Although with the Ariarch champion gaining them life, maybe that's just not true. But we're also, I think I'm going to go end of turn salvaging, discard mending, and then we have like a really good chance to find another Phoenix or another Bolt. We have a Bolt in the yard and a Gutshot to flashback from the Liches. Oh, and you know, like I said, I reading too much into my opponent's indecision here. The game log says they've lost connection to the game. It does say that they've rejoined, so maybe we'll see them put some creatures in play, and maybe the channel fireball editor will skip ahead a bit. We're gonna get Spike Feeder, Skyclave Apparition. It's kind of interesting. Definitely alive. Definitely alive. I think. Yeah, they go up to 7, and then they can gain 4 from Feeder up to 11. Okay, maybe definitely alive is a bit of a stretch, but I think likely alive is going to be the case here. They target one of the Dimuliches with the Skyclave. Which I guess is fine. I'm not sure which is better, just because like this never gets blocked. But it's not like they have good blocks on the Lich, so I guess this makes sense. Any moment now, it'll be my turn again. The moment is now. So I'm an upkeep stop here. So usually in response to salvaging, you'll want to respond with consider because you might draw into a Phoenix or Lich that you want to discard. But with consider, we're just going to put this Phoenix in the graveyard and then we could potentially draw another Phoenix, but I'll just discard the Scalding Tarn. So we've already cast two spells now. And so this Metamorphose will be spell number 3 for this Phoenix. Okay. And so we can also go... We can go Metamorphose into Flashback Mending, discard Phoenix. So I'll make blue, white, Flashback Mending. And then I'll Shock in the Steam Vents. And then I think I'll Bolt the Spike Feeder? Do I Bolt the Sky Feeder? I think I Bolt the Spike Feeder. And then Think how relevant gutshotting them is. So Bolt Spike Feeder, they gain 4 up to 13. Okay, they've conceded. Thank you. It's good because there's a lot of math to be done here that I didn't really want to do. Okay, so we have to think about sideboarding. Sanctifier and Vec and Rest in Peace are likely to be sideboard cards. They can also have Endurance. Endurance is, I think, the scariest card to play against because you just like don't really have good answers to it. Prismatic Ending is great against them. This card is probably going to be a little taxed in the matchup, you know what I mean? Where, like, you sometimes you just want to kill a mana creature, but then, like, if they play Utopia Sprawl or Arbor Elf on 1 and you have Ending, you're kind of in a weird spot where you're like, I want to answer this, but I also want to save this for Rest in Peace or Sanctifier. So we're going to have to try to figure that out. I think that I'm interested in at least the first Wear Tear, where like this has targets beyond just Rest in Peace, where you can also hit Utopia Sprawl, you can hit Walking Ballista. I think I'm also interested in at least the first Path, maybe two copies of Path. Let's see, I think I can trim a Salvaging. I think I want all the Bolts to break up their combo, but maybe I'll trim one Bolt if I'm bringing in Paths, where Path can also answer Ariok Champion, which can be kind of a hard card to deal with. I can trim the fourth Serum Visions. This looks pretty good to me. And then if we end up seeing like a lot of Rest in Pieces for game 2, then maybe I'll bring in another Wear Tear. Okay, I like this hand a lot. This hand, you know, having the ability to kill Arbor Elf, we have got cantrips, we have an answer to a Sanctifier or Ariok Champion or Rest in Peace, feeling pretty good. And my opponent's bold to six. And this has been something that I've noticed a few times playing this deck, is that your opponents will mold a five or six to find a Rest in Peace or Chalice or Sanctifier, and you'll just Prismatic Ending it, and then they'll be like pretty behind on cards. If they play Utopia Sprawl on one, I'm probably supposed to ending. Was hoping, of course, they'd play Arbor Elf, but you know, nothing is also acceptable, of course. Also, both Scalding Tarn and Flooded Strand find all of our fetches, or all of our fetchable targets, so you don't need to really worry too much about which one you play. Or maybe I should say the order you play them. So yeah, if I'm going to play Sanctifier or Rest in Peace, I think I'm just getting a tapped Fountain, and then I'm going to answer it with Ending. Okay, they played Ariok Champion, which isn't a lock piece. I might still Prismatic Ending it next turn, but at least for right now, I think I'm just going to go Scour. I usually cast Scour before Consider, because Scour is a cantrip that requires you to make no decisions when you cast it. And so you usually want to make... You use the cantrip that requires you to actually make decisions on the... You know, on a later turn, so you have more information, if that makes sense. I don't think I did a great job explaining that, but you guys are smart. You guys picking up what I'm putting down. So let's make blue. And then we can try to Serum Visions and Scry a Demi-Lich or a Phoenix to the top, or I can just go Thought Scour plus Consider. That puts three cards in the yard, and this sees potentially four total. Yeah, I think we're supposed to Serum Visions first. Just one more card. Wow, both. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I mean, I think I don't really have any choice but go top Scour, but I think I can only have enough instants and sorceries to play one of the two liches from the yard, but just having another one in the yard is fine, right? So I have to gut shot here to get that fourth spell for the liches, and let me just double check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I only play one lich from the graveyard on turn two. We'll get over it somehow, I think. Let me leave. I think Lightning Bolt Metamorphosis. You know, I know that this game and last game, I've been able to get creatures back on turn two. Turn three is usually the turn you're getting your stuff back. Just so people don't get too excited. We've had some very good draws here. But you guys can get like a little excited. Heliod, which is going to meet its Prismatic Ending here. And you're just ending the Heliod, not take chances here. We need to stop them from comboing us. I have a chance to kill them next turn, not a super likely chance. You don't have, so if you target something with Demi-Lich, you exile the card from the yard, even if you don't cast it. And so in order to get around that on Magic Line, you just click OK instead of actually targeting anything. It took me a little while to realize that's what I had to click. So I can save you guys the trouble there. I think my opponent has Utopia Sprawl and the Collected Company. Just like the way they're pausing. They definitely had Sprawl with the way they like retap the mana there. And then it just kind of feel like Company is coming as well. Maybe not. Is this Ballista? Ballista is like the only spell that's, you know, kind of tricky to cast like this. Yeah, Magic Online makes you like click the mana kind of weirdly. Okay, just a Spike Feeder. which I think I will try to prioritize using Dimmy Lich to Lightning Bolt. So we're probably not killing them this turn. Maybe we're killing them this turn. I can go Lightning Bolt, Spike Feeder, Faithful Mending, Consider, and then that brings back the Phoenix, and I attack for 10, which is not lethal because I can't also flash back the Bolt off the Lich. It is lethal if I find another Phoenix. So let me go Consider first. Yes, put that in the graveyard. Could also get back Dimmy Lich. But I feel like drawing Path, I just want to try to... I have Path and Bolt in my hand. I feel like I can afford to play this game, like, super safe, so... And then likely kill them next turn. Yeah, so I think I just like Bolt Spike Feeder, they gain 4, then we likely hit them for 7 unless they jump block. So they'll be down to 7 life. And then we have Path plus Bolt up. Oh, sorry, I miscounted there. There, 15. Still very likely to have lethal next turn. And even if we don't, like, we still have, you know, also a lot of interaction that they have to fight through, and they only have 2 cards. So they're done fighting. We win match number 1. Pretty good showing for the deck. I'll see you guys in round number 2. Okay, we are on the draw for match number 2. I think I'm going to keep this hand. Totally reasonable. I any hand that has, you know, at least 2 lands and a Mana Morphos is a hand that I'm usually pretty interested in keeping. This card just enables so many strong turns. All right, basic island go. Could be the mirror match. I haven't played the mirror yet. Could be Reanimator too. Reanimator is I think a tough matchup. If it is the mirror, they've drawn both of their basic islands. I'm trying to think. It could also just be Blue Red Murktide. Okay, so usually in the spot, I like to set up for a turn by casting Salvaging. Just like starting your turn with the Rebound of Salvaging just gives you a really good chance to have a strong turn 3. Scours themselves, mills Flintstrand third island. So third island rules off my opponent copying my deck list. And then they milled over Snapcaster Mage. So possibly Blue Moon with so many islands. That would be my guess here. So I think I'll probably get a basic island end of turn. And then I think we'll discard Mending for a little bit of value. Dimmy Lich is a very good draw. I think I'll discard the Dimmy Lich for, again, a little bit of value. So I've cast 1 spell so far. If I cast Mana Morphos, that's 2. And even if my opponent counters Mana Morphos, I still get Dimmy Lich back from the yard. So let's just start off with this. Because I can go Serum Vision's Gutshot. Okay, so that is a Phoenix. So I've cast 2 spells. So I'm going to cast Mending. And hopefully Mending resolves. Flashback on Mending is just such a big deal, because then I can go Gutshot. So I have 1, 2, I have exactly 4 spells in the yard. I think I want to discard, I'll have 4 spells after I Gutshot. Not sure how much sequencing matters. I'm just going to do this now. It's okay if they counter this. just be able to cast it again pretty quickly. Yeah. Really happy to trade the Lich for the Charm there, because it's just in the yard, and I have four spells that'll be able to get this back in a turn or two. So playing blue-white control, I found this matchup to be really good. I haven't played it. I've played it like maybe five times. I think I'm like 5-0 against it. And even like their main deck Chalices, you think would do a lot of work. We just have all these main deck endings, you know. Although it looks like my opponent's playing Murktide in blue-white. It's kind of interesting. Very interesting. I guess that makes sense, you know, seeing all these Thought Scours. Murktide can be a hard card to deal with. I might chump block it and then try to reanimate everything or multiple things next turn. Let me cast a Serum Visions here. Salvaging Island. I think we'll bottom both of these. Play a Tap Canal Pass. Hopefully no path deck. So I didn't mention this in the deck tech, but a big boon for this archetype is that Path to Exile is just not a popular card in Modern right now. And you know, we'll see if it ever is again, I guess. But it's just not a popular card, so that just makes your creatures very, very resilient to most removal in the format. We have a chance to kill them next turn. We also have a chance to just take 7, but maybe the mending will just give me enough life to survive. Necryptic by salvaging. I think I'm okay with that. I mean, I have to be at least. So we'll start off with mending, which puts me to 8, which makes me not dead to this. Then I guess I discard. Yeah, I don't want to fetch and put myself dead to the Murktide attack. So my options are just bolt them, get back Phoenix, put them to 1. But then I'm dead to a bolt or any burn spell. I can also go... I can play a second mending here. I fetch shock down to 6, and I gain 2... down to 5, I gain 2 up to 7. Again, that puts me dead to 1 Murktide swing. But if I find another Phoenix, it's pretty good for me. I can also go bolt them, leave Phoenix back to block, replay Demi-Lich. Which is kind of interesting too. I think no matter what line I take, besides bolt them, leave Phoenix back to chump, which I don't really like that much. I think I'm dead to a burn spell. Which I do not love. This is really tough. I think I'm gonna go for this line. This line is good against like everything besides a burn spell. Like this can be counter spells. This can be planeswalkers. This can be this turns off their flooded strand potentially. Whereas like leaving back the Phoenix to chump like is like soft to like Teferi Time Raveler, soft to Cryptic Command. They do have 4 cards in their hand. They do have the bolt, but I feel like this line was fine. All right, gonna go to the next game, and I am gonna bring in my Path to Exiles. And I don't think my opponent's gonna be playing Rest in Peace if they're playing Murktide. So maybe I'll just go -2 gut shots, +2 path. I don't usually care too much for Flusterstorm in these matchups, where they just don't seem like they really counter the important cards. Where your deck is like really good against removal and counter spells, right? But just off to like their creatures, their planeswalkers, their like artifacts and enchantments. So we're on the play for round 2. I'm gonna keep this hand. And let's get Fountain. Thought Scour. Again, usually Scour before Consider. Lower Scour, Metamorphose, draw a second ending. Pass back. Just see what they do. I'm not sure if I'm going to lead on Mending or if I'm going to go Consider. I think I'll go Mending. I kind of want to loot away at least one of these Prismatic Endings. And like the multiple Considers will let me like potentially play three spells next turn, and which is gives me a much better chance to Phoenix next turn as well. I'm pretty happy with them Flusterstorm and Mending. You know, this has Flashback. Don't really care too much about that. Yeah, let's go. Metamorphose, Consider. Blue. Or should I say, I guess it's Serum Visions, Consider. And then, yeah, I'll go ahead and take an Island. Just this because this will give me a chance to, if I find Dimulich or Phoenix off this Consider, get one of those back. I guess specifically this gives me Dimulich back. So I did get to mill a Phoenix. It's only one creature back on turn three, but like, you know, this is pretty good, especially considering they Flusterstormed. They're down to 14, and it's nice that they can't really Murktide either in this spot. So yeah, I don't think I'm into all this open mana. I'm supposed to try to main phase get this Phoenix back. I'm happy to draw that. And I, you know, they did counter my salvaging last turn. I think that maybe most players wouldn't have in that spot. Opponents maybe, you know, familiar with how powerful salvaging can be. Yeah, so I think in response, and this is bad against Graveyard Hate, but they're playing Murktide, so I'm not going to expect it that much. I just want to try to resolve salvaging. And I just kind of can't stress this enough. Like, salvaging sets up for so many powerful turns. Just starting that turn with that zero mana spell is such a big game. I'm going to discard one of my endings here. That's not bad. And that is not only not bad, but very, very good. If they do counter this Metamorphose, I don't think we can Lich, but we'll get back both Phoenixes. Or we can Lich if we find a Gutshot or a red source for Bolt. I just feel like this is a good showcase of why you don't really need Flusterstorm or why you don't really care about your opposing counter spells. You're just so good at playing through them. Another Phoenix and a land. I think I'm interested in both of these. I think I'd rather draw the Tarn first. Let me just like try to... Yeah, I can just consider the Phoenix into the yard and then go Mending Bolt. Assuming my opponent's, you know, not conceded. Or they haven't conceded. A little bit of a pun there, I guess. Put that on top. Scour themselves. So they might Murktide here, but I think they're dead if they tap out for Murktide. So we're going to draw Phoenix, and then we go consider draw Scalding Tarn. Or I guess I should upkeep, consider the Phoenix into the yard, draw Scalding Tarn, draw Phoenix, and then we go Mending, discard Phoenix, discard Lich. Shouldn't matter that much. And then we can just path the Murktide, attack for 9. Could also have bolted then. That could have been a bit better to not show my opponent path. Good showing. I've been really liking this deck. I don't think it's, you know, broken or anything, but it's been really powerful so far. Okay, I'm gonna resubmit this. Like my sideboard plan. All right, well, I like this hand too. My opponent's mulled to 6. I mentioned earlier, hands with multiple Metamorphoses are usually really enticing. Obviously, we need to find a discard outlet, but we've got a lot in the deck, and there's one. Let's go bottom both of these. If my opponent plays Chalice, we can even still play Phoenix next turn. And they're also probably not playing Chalice the way they've shown us a lot of one mana spells, actually. I guess into 2 open mana. I'm probably not supposed to go for the turn two Phoenixes. But I will just make sure I can resolve the salvaging, because if they counter it, it's such a disaster. Kind of rough for them to, I said that, so they're missing lands, I guess is why they ran that out there. But kind of rough for them to have to do that on the mold of five, right? Third Metamorphose. I'm going to go ahead and start off by casting one, and then if it gets countered, probably just gutshot the Snapcaster, get Phoenix back. Bounce Phoenix. We don't have another discard outlet in our hand. If I draw a land, I'll just, I think, hard cast. Might still end up doing that. I guess I'll make white, blue. Okay, so we didn't draw the land, so cast two spells. Let's just go Bolt Demulich. I can't Prismatic Ending Demulich because I'm one mana short. All right, four cards in their hand. They bolt to Demulich, which is fine with me. Blue. We're going to play 5/5 Murktide Regent. Also okay with me. If I draw a land or zero mana spell, I get Lich back. Let's cast that. I know that. Okay, so great. Just all worked out here. So it's like a little bit risky to like maybe like not get to path this turn, and then they get to maybe protect their regent with some counter magic. But everything worked out. We don't get the Lich back this turn, but we do get our Phoenix back, which is probably as much as we can ask for. Next turn, theoretically, we can just Ending target Phoenix, which won't exile the Phoenix, but it'll cast a spell off the Tarn, and we can use the other three blue mana to cast Demulich. Let's see, just see what happens. I think my opponent has Aether Gust, the way they like paused on my upkeep there. Kind of makes sense to me to have Aether Gust. But they take three down to eight. Let's cast Consider. Yeah, we can draw Lightning Bolt. This gives me another spell to cast Lich, and then obviously, you know, their life total's not particularly high. Dispute that. Okay, that's fine. Cast Lich from the graveyard. Let's exile Gutshot, Metamorphose, Salvaging, Ending? Probably doesn't matter that much. Two cards left. One of them countering the Demulich, which is totally fine with me. Okay, one of the two cards is a Steam Vents. It's fine again. I think I start off with Mending. Discard. And then let's cast Lich. Discarding or exiling. I want to leave Path in here. Let's exile Metamorphose, one of the Bolts, and then Seraph Visions. Okay, they snap Dispute. But they're out of cards. They have a Phoenix in play, a Phoenix and a Demulich in the yard. They draw Murktide. It's a 4/4, though, which blocks my Phoenix. Obviously, they have some good draws, right? Looks like they did draw Murktide. Yeah, we've got a game. We do have a lot of good, crazy series of draws, right? Always a nice thing is like your top decks can be really good. Just chaining cantrips together, getting your creatures back. That's a good start. Drew Mending. Mending's a bit awkward here. I think we just flash back Mending. Okay, so I think this is lethal. I discard here, bolt my opponent, get back a bird, put my opponent to zero. All right, 2-0. I'll see you guys in round number 3. Okay, we're on the play for match number 3 of this league. Opponent had to take a little break at the beginning, but hopefully they're here. Okay. Sounds like a little bit risky, right? We need to find a land, but we've got 2 cantrips, and if we do find the land, we have a Phoenix and a Salvaging and a Metamorphos to have a definitely powerful turn 3, maybe powerful turn 2. They go stomping around tapped on 1, no companion. Well, I definitely want to draw Floated Strand. And do I want a main phase? I guess let's upkeep the Salvaging. They could be Team of Rhinos, and they play Force Negation. I really can't afford to have this Salvaging forced, I think, with this hand. Kind of a painful start. Shock, Fetch Shock, but maybe Mending will allow us to gain some of that life back. What am I discarding with Salvaging? Maybe the Mending? Maybe I'll discard the Lightning Bolts. Let's discard them. I'm not sure about this. Okay, well, this is really bad if my opponent counters the Metamorphos. I think I'm still supposed to play it here, because they did not. Awesome. So let's make blue-white and Mending so we can definitely get a Phoenix back. And if we draw a land, now we can also get the Demi Lich. Didn't draw the land. It's kind of a bummer. I think I'll just discard. I mean, this is still a very good turn 3. But, like, if we had found the land, then this game is, like, maybe just, like, a definite win. Whereas we might lose to Rhinos, you know. But it does seem like what they're playing. They probably can kill one of my Phoenixes. Okay. Get in with the other one. I haven't played a ton of this matchup. I think I'm like 2-0 in this matchup so far. It does feel like you can outpower what they're doing a decent amount of the time. And it also feels like we have like more good sideboard cards than they do. Although I guess it kind of depends on how many endurances they're playing, I suppose. All right, so let me start off with Serum Visions. Bottom, draw land, bottom 2 lands. And then I guess I can ending target my own Phoenix to get another Phoenix back. So I'll leave this up just so I can definitely get a Phoenix back here. It does kind of stink because I kind of wanted to ending a Rhino, but I think we're also in a position where we could race. I assume that they're going to Violent Outburst. Yeah. We attack them down to 10, and then they attack me down to 8, and then we attack them down to 4. And if we could find some damage, we're in good shape. And we can also, like, Mending also makes me not dead to just these Rhinos attacks, but they can probably present lethal through just the 2 extra life. If we had found the land off Mending so we could have cast Lich, I think this game is pretty over. Okay, interesting. I think I'm going to get Basic Island, Serum Visions. Interesting. So this is theoretically lethal. The second gutshot lets me double Lich too. I discard the Dibby Lich. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, okay. Seems fine. So let's just go to text first. Oh my gosh. Forgot to cast the gutshot. I'm sorry. I thought I already cast 3 spells. So embarrassing. Sorry, I thought that was the third spell. I should have obviously double checked first. Sloppy play on my part. But we can cast both Dimmy Liches from the yard, and like this is gonna at least like not put a stud on board. So we're gonna go to seven because you can pay mana for gut shot, pay life for gut shot, play lich, block. My opponent's maybe has like Brazen Borrower. They think about blocking. Just gonna Petty Theft. So it looks like we weren't killing them this turn anyways. So obviously having a second Phoenix in play right now would give me a much better chance at actually winning this game, but yeah, this is the game we're playing. Let's just move on. Yeah, they'd be at three. Okay, so Linux Owl, at least a gut shot. Salvaging, Metamorphose, Scour. And then play another Witch, Exiling. I feel like I probably am not going to want to flashback gut shot. I also probably am not going to play both Mendings from the yard. I might want to flashback an Ending and kill a Rhino. So let's go. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I saw Mending, one of the two bolts that got shot. I guess I probably should just go after cantrips though. Yeah, I usually like consider more than Sand Visions. Let's just do that. So they deal with one lich, we take 5, 6. Yeah, we're exactly at one if they can only deal with one lich. But of course, we're now dead to Borrower, Fire Ice, another Petty Theft, and Vinyl Outburst. So, and Fury now that they have the land. So it's pretty tough to not be dead here. Okay, cool. Can't help but look at my opponent's two life though, and look at the Phoenix that I didn't return. Just have to make up for in games 2 and 3. We do get to bring in, you know, the chalices, the fluster storms. I don't like surgical that much, but it might end up making the cut because I also like want to cut all the prismatic endings and one of the gut shots. And I could even see surgical being a bit better than gut shot because if we can counter one rhino or one footfalls, or like even like if they just cascade once in response to another cascader, you can surgical. That could be better. They'll just split gut shot, one surgical, one gut shot. Seems fine. I don't think it's going to be that good, but I think you're probably not that unhappy just to draw it since you can loot it away. And, you know, worst case scenario, it's a zero mana spell. Okay, on the play for game number 2 against Teemer Rhinos. I don't love that this hand doesn't have a creature or a lock piece, or a sideboard card. We do have Metamorphose, and we do have a cantrip. I think I wouldn't fault anyone for keeping this hand, but I'm going to send it back, and then I'm going to wish I could take that back and keep that 7 card hand, because I would like it more than any 6. But this is a fine 5. Totally fine 5. Let me put back definitely a Dimmy Lich. And then salvaging is gonna be the cantrip I cast on 2. I think I'll get a little greedy and put back mending. And if I can, you know, consider into a red source salvaging and hopefully chain a couple more cantrips together, we can have a semi-explosive turn 3. And, you know, maybe we can also find a Fluster Storm or Chalice. Hope they don't dispute my consider. That would be pretty bad. Putting Metamorphose in the graveyard hurts. have to, I think. And we didn't find the land this time. Just one of those hands. Feels, of course, I apologize for messing up the first turn, or the turn in game one. My bad. Can still win this game if we draw the land, though. Okay. Be pretty cool to win this one. Kind of stinks because I don't think we can afford to play around Violent Outburst this game. They're shocking twice here. Well, I'm shocked to see that. Yeah, let's just salvage here. If they force some negation, I'm not happy, but this is, I think, the line. Okay, resolved. Discard Phoenix. Draw land, which is less than ideal. It'd be really good for us if they try to counter the rebound. Because then we're just like one more spell towards these Phoenixes and Liches, because we get to cast the Flusterstorm. I'm going to discard a Lich with the rebound. They missed their land drop. Dude, winning this game would be awesome. Winning this game would be so cool. They discard Brazen Borrower. So this resolves. We draw Gutshots. Okay, so I can go Gutshot them. Flusterstorm my Gutshot. Don't pay. Play Demi-Lich. All right, I mean, this is all we have, so let's do it. I didn't think I'd be Flusterstorming my own spell, but you gotta do what you gotta do sometimes. And I think I'll immediately play the Demi-Lich to play around Endurance. Oh, no. Wait, my opponent has Surgical in their deck? What the... Are they just going to cascade at the Surgical Extraction? I guess not. I guess they're just not going to cascade in the Surgical. Sheesh. But it says, sorry, brother. Watched the stream yesterday, lol. All right, I don't have the heart to tell them. I mean, maybe it's just, I'll just cascade in Surgical and that'll be good. Let's go, probably just best to move on, I think. See you guys around number four. Okay, so we are on the draw for match number four of this league. I'm gonna keep this hand. It doesn't need a little help, we've got some cantrips and I want to continue to stress Metamorphose. That's an important card to keep. Playing is Elves. We are a Gutshot deck, so I guess I'm going to Thought Scour. I'll consider first, just because I'd really like to find Gutshot. I get to put a Demi-Lich in the graveyard. An interesting matchup. We're going to have a really powerful turn three. The problem is we're on the draw against Elves and we don't have any interaction, so it might not matter. If we'd won the die roll, I'd be feeling pretty happy to bring back two Phoenixes and probably a Lich on turn three. Draw Lightning Bolts. Do I have to bolt the Elvish War Master? I really want to cast Salvaging this turn. Yeah, I think I just have to cast Salvaging. Hope the damage isn't too bad. I wonder if they're playing Rite of Harmony. I tested out Rite of Harmony and Elves a little bit. It felt fine. It's not sure it was better than some of the other cards. I also wonder if they're playing Endurance. So as long as they don't find Heritage Druid, the Realmwalker isn't that scary this turn. We can bolt it next turn. Okay, that was off the top. They might shuffle to get another look at Heritage Druid. Take 3 down to 17. Salvaging, discard Phoenix. Rebound, salvaging, discard Phoenix. Draw Mending. We could Mending off of Mana Morphos if we wanted to. I think I'd rather go Mana Morphos, blue, Serum Visions, Thought Scour. Well, that did not work out. I was hoping to like scry into a Phoenix and be able to mill it. I'll be okay. So this is my fourth spell cast this turn. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna leave Mana Morphos consider in the yard. Stimulich, Bolt Realmwalker, give back 2 Phoenixes, and then I think I'm just attacking with both here. But shuffles, like them for 6, down to 12. Might be able to kill them next. Yeah, actually just the Lightning Bolt is going to be lethal next turn. So they have to kill me or interact somehow, and Elves is not great at interacting. Yeah, I can just go Bolt, then let's back the Bolt. Can maybe also get this Phoenix in play. It's kind of like at least a free roll with the Mending. Rite of Harmony, 2 cards left. They really need Heritage Druid for this to be good. They get to go Warmaster, draw a card, Warmaster, draw a card. Okay, it's pretty cool. But if they don't find Heritage Druid, we're not gonna be in bad shape. Glad to see some people are working on this, because I did play like I think I only played 3 matches before moving on to other stuff. I do feel like there's potential here. Sentinel, draw a card. Mystic, draw a card. They still have their land drop though, so we're almost out of the woods, assuming no Cord of Calling, and I don't think that they play Cord. I didn't have it in any of my drafts, but it's obviously a possible card to play. There's Canopy, so if they cast Druid off Canopy, we're in bad shape. Quarian Ranger. Okay, so this gives them 1 more mana, because they can untap an elf. I think they've bricked. That was a really powerful turn though. It was cool to get to see that. But they're very dead, I think. Metamorphos, blue white, mending. Bolt them, get back Phoenix, replay Bolt off Lich. So even if they somehow have answered to like one of these things, I guess they could have Endurance blue card in their hand, or green card in their hand. They do not, and we win game 1 against Elves, even though it was looking a little scary there on the draw. I might not be sideboarding. I don't really like Path against Elves. Ending's not that good, I guess, either. It's good against their 1 mana spells, but not so good against their more expensive ones. might play like one path over like Sarah Visions number four. I just don't like that. Just like ramping them is so tough because they have so many sinks though. I think that's fine. Just play one. Let's go to game two. Matchup team is fine. We got Shut Deck. Dimmy Lich is also really good in these kinds of matchups where they can't really answer it and you can just flashback removal spells over and over with it. Okay, so we're on the draw. My opponent's kept seven. This hand has no removal spells, which is kind of tough. But like I mentioned, Dimmy Lich is really good in this matchup, and we have, you know, card selection here. It's not the end of the world if they get to untap with an elf, right? Although, maybe it is. Okay, that lets us Dimmy Lich next turn. Let me try to Serum Visions and set up for an even more powerful turn next turn. There's an ending. That's pretty good. I think I can keep another Scour. Yeah, so next turn we probably go Manamorphose, Thought Scour, Ending Lich. This is the best card in the deck, Manamorphose, I think. Hope this turn isn't too good. Yeah. I mean, we could obviously like draw into a Lightning Bolt. Just go blue-red to see what we find. Another Ending, which isn't very good against Archdruid. Yeah, I think I'll still just make blue-white, unfortunately. Did not find a Lightning Bolt. Thought Scour myself. I guess first I might path this if I draw path. Didn't draw path, which is probably for the best. That's not a line anybody should have to make. main phase path on turn two. I get to play Lich. Letting, you know, when the Elves players get to untap with Elvish Archdruid, it's always pretty terrifying. But next turn, we can, if we, you know, replay Ending off Dimmy Lich, exile this, and or potentially play Ending from hand, exile this, and replay Gutshot for zero mana. If they give us a Gutshot target when it's tanking, so they likely have a lot of decisions. All right, they're starting. Forest has been tapped for green mana for a Nettle Sentinel. Then they tap Archdruid, three mana, and Temple Garden, three mana for. Okay, I decided to not do that. They're passing. Okay. So they must have path. Let me just go to combat here. I'm trying to flashback the prismatic ending. Okay. They can't cast Coco. They have Endurance. Okay. You know, Endurance is an excellent sideboard card against us. It all said and done, if this is how they're going to use Endurance, we really can't complain too much. We still get to ending the Archdruid and have a very high chance for a good turn next turn. I think Endurance is the best sideboard card against us. I mean, Surgical is very good too. Saw how good it was there last game. Even in Teemer Rhinos. They take the 4, which is fine. I don't know. Letting me untap with the Demi-Lich is... I don't know. It's concerning, right? Because I get to flashback potentially some interactive spells. Maybe they were supposed to block. I'm not sure. It kind of depends on, you know, the contents of their hand. It might depend on the contents of their heart. And those are just two things I don't know. Warmaster, untap Sentinel. We'll have to find a Bolt. I'll take a second Demi-Lich. Can't complain about that one. So it's Manamorphose. I think we make blue-white. Dramatic ending, interesting. I can go Prismatic Ending the War Master, Flashback Manamorphose, and then Mending, and then just play the Lich for 0 mana. That which is not good if I find a Phoenix, but it's good if I find more Liches. I can also flashback ending on Nettle Sentinel and Thought Scour myself. That could be a bit better. It's kind of close. I think I'm going to Manamorphose. I think this is going to set up for a stronger turn next turn to get the extra card. My opponent might have Endurance here. They don't have to. I guess if they Endurance, then it's like not bad at all for us. Yeah, we just go Thought Scour, then cast the Lich for 1 mana. Yeah, this is a super good exchange for us. Especially when like Endurance is such a high value card. They pitch the Rite of Harmony, which, if you're trying to figure out how good it is for your deck, didn't seem to be that too good there. Then I think I'll Scour. If we draw Bolt, we'll Bolt this, and we still get to play the Lich. Still get to play the Lich after the Visions. We also build over a Phoenix. Keep Consider on top. Dude, I love this deck. This deck is a blast. And they're only have 2 cards in their hand. They've already used 2 Endurances. We are at 8, but they don't, I think, have good attacks. We block the Sentinel, take 3 from Endurance, probably. They just concede, so. 3-1, I'll see you guys in the last round. Nice 4-1 would be pretty good to get. Okay, we are on the draw for the last match of this league. I'm going to keep this hand. So 1 lander, but we've got a lot of cantrips, and we've got a discard outlet, we've got a turn 1 Bolts. These hands got a lot of upside. It's got Serum Visions, looking basically just for a creature. Bond both of these pretty easily. Misty Rainforest Go, so it could be playing Rhinos again. Could be playing a plethora of decks. There's a lot of blue decks in the format. Could be Living End. I kind of hope it's not. Living End's, you know, it's not like the worst matchup, but it feels really complicated to me. It's like... their Living Ends are, it's like, you kind of have like this weird dynamic of like bringing back your creatures before they Living End or filling up your graveyard to like have a big board after they Living End. Just kind of a pain. does look like they're playing rhinos. But I feel like I found that play draw seems like it matters the most. And rhinos, let me probably discard Tarn. It's a bit greedy. But we're about to cantrip a lot, so I think we have a good chance to find another land. I'll discard Ending. Okay, maybe he's a bit too greedy. Hopefully they don't force the Metamorphose. All right, they did. Yeah. Tough stuff. Might just be 0-2 against rhinos this league. Maybe with Jell Cyborg card. I guess we drew the Flusterstorm last time. I will say that I think that this rhino's opponent is probably less likely to have surgical extraction than our other opponent, huh? Build over a Phoenix. I think I'm going to scour again. I think it's the highest upside. I missed. Okay. Yeah, we really needed that Metamorphose to resolve. I also got kind of greedy discarding the land. I think it was fine. Like, theoretically, we're going to draw like 5 new cards, which had a good chance to find the land. So this is what I did the last time. I played one Surgical over the second Gutshot. I think that's still fine. Like, neither are good, but both are just like mostly a 0 mana spell here. And I think you're probably not that unhappy to draw the first Surgical, at least in theory. On the play, opponent's playing super fast, which I always like. Keep this. Opponent's mold to 6. Our hand's great. This hand's really strong. Graveyard the Steam Vents, draw Metamorphose, which is a fantastic addition to the hand. I think I'm going to upkeep Salvaging. We really want the Salvaging to resolve. And if you're looking to fight against this deck, I think countering the turn 2 Salvaging is really important. I found that Salvaging tends to be the better, between Salvaging and Mending, it tends to be the better looting effect on turn 2, and then Mending is usually better after turn 2. I think I'm discarding Mending. It's just the most expensive card in the hand, and you know, we can flash it back potentially. And here, if they force my Metamorphose, I can Flusterstorm back. Okay, they didn't. Blue, Serum Visions. Bottom, top, consider mill over the Dimulich, draw a new card. Which was Chalice of the Void. Wow, what a turn. What a turn. We even have Flusterstorm to counter Surgical. Double check this isn't the same Rhino's player. It's not. Endurance, though, is very good against us here. And you know what? I made a mistake here. This is a mistake that you can avoid in the future. Is I should have just played the Dimulich immediately to play around the Endurance. That being said, we're not in bad shape. We've got, you know, a lot of interaction here for their Rhinos combo. They're missing a land drop. We're doing okay. I think I'm just going to discard the Strand end of turn. Hope to rebuild. Although, if I play the Strand, I get to shuffle a Lich and a Phoenix back in because those went on the bottom of my library. I think that this is fine. Maybe I'll discard a Flusterstorm, though. I'm not sure if I'm going to need this many copies. Clothis. Yeah, let me discard Flusterstorm. Then we'll discard a Strand. Hopefully we can get something going here. Looks like we will. Might bring in a Prismatic Ending for game 3. I mean, just answering Clothis is not that good. It's not that good against a lot of other cards. But Clothis is strong against us. It's got Mending, discard Tarn. Tarn other Mending, probably. Does value being in the yard. It's got a Lich. They're going to exile one of my two Mendings. Clothis. can theoretically flashback the other one in response to the Klothys trigger next turn. I just cast it off the Dimmy Lich. Discard another Seasoned Pyromancer and a Shardless Agent. They pass. Let's cast the Manamorphose, and then I might use the mana for Manamorphose to flashback Mending, because I feel like that two life is pretty relevant here. We'll see. Let's make red, blue. It's an interesting draw. I'll flashback the Mending. Storm counts four, so we need to cast one more spell or just spend a mana if we end up drawing a second copy of Lich. We shuffled the one that got Endurance back into, for those of you remembering. So let's discard, I think, just discard Canal Tarn. We can cast the Gutshot to cast the Lich. I was hoping that they would block like this. Kind of hard for them to play around Gutshot there. And then I'm going to set upkeep stop. Remember that salvaging does not force you to discard a card first. So if salvaging is the last card in your hand, it ends up being a little bit of card advantage, which is of course nice. Not a very helpful top of the library. I guess I'll target the Gutshot and then not target anything with the other Dimmy Lich trigger. And then we can Gutshot spinning a mana to kill the elemental token. And maybe they'll Seasoned Pyromancer chump chump. Maybe they'll Seasoned Pyromancer block one. Block none. Okay, I think I like that. I like the block none. With the Klothys, they're definitely racing here, right? Remember, we have the salvaging rebound. We can flashback salvaging with Lich. Also, remember, if you flashback salvaging with Lich, you don't get to rebound because rebound specifies that it has to be cast from the hand to work. Okay, so their hand must be pretty weak if they're going to leave back these elementals. I draw Consider for turn. Another Lich, which I like. Definitely going to be able to play that pretty well here. I think I'll graveyard that. Weird draw. All right, let's just attack with both Liches. Flashback, consider Manamorphose. You want to target the Consider first. The Manamorphose resolves first, and you can use the mana on the Consider. I think I'm making blue. Well, if we can find a Mending for next turn, that'd be pretty good. Yes, put that in the graveyard. Okay, we drew the third Phoenix. I mean, we could just start hard casting these two. It's kind of funny. Double block is interesting to me. They have Violent Outburst, maybe? Just to buff these guys? And I don't have enough instants or sorceries in my yard to replay a Lich. I can just play the one in my hand, though. I'll exile the Lich with Klothys, probably. We don't have lethal because of the life gain from Klothys, but if we just draw Mending, we've got a really good chance to kill them. What a weird game. Bolt. I guess if I cast Hardcast Phoenix, I don't get to play Bolt off the Lich too, which I think I'd rather do here. They have an endurance though, which is not great for us. So much graveyard hate. They probably block. Can't replay the Lich. Gets exiled by Clothis. They go up to 8. We go down to 4. Not quite lethal next turn. Could have lethal for Joel Mending or Bolt. They have 3 cards. Likely at least one or two of these. It's getting stopped by Chalice. Maybe if they're Shardless Agent, they just played out. They had at least one Violent Outburst earlier. But they have the Seasoned Pyromancer to get back again. I drew Bolt again, which is kind of a funny draw, right? But it's not quite lethal. So I think I'm just going to go Phoenix, attack with both. I'm not dead next turn, though, which is nice. I want to not make sure that this Bolt is not going to get targeted by Clothis. They're dead if they don't shunt block here, which is important because otherwise they would be able to attack me for lethal. They can just not play around Bolt here by just attacking me for 4 and not blocking the Lich, but I don't like that line so much because like the Seasoned Pyromancer is just, it's there, it's in play. They should infer that I know it's up, right? And if I knew it was up, I wouldn't have attacked the Lich. That being said, we're dead to Stomp, we're dead to Fire, we're dead to... not dead to Violent Outburst because we can Bolt the Elemental token. We are dead to Fire. So, ended up being 3-2, lost to Rhinos both times. I have liked that matchup before, but maybe my draws were just particularly good. I mean, I did punts in match number 3 against Rhinos the first time this league, so a little bit of playtesting there. Also, getting Surgical by Rhinos was a bit weird. But I'm really, really liking this deck. I think this was a good league to at least like showcase what this deck is doing, showcase the power of the deck, the consistency, the explosiveness. This deck obviously has weaknesses. You know, Surgical Extraction, as we saw, is very good against the deck, but it's also very powerful and resilient to a lot of other hates, which it makes it worth playing. I really recommend this deck, and I hope you enjoyed the video. See you next week. Bye.